around, get acquainted, see how we do things.
It's time for another 2-minute tech tip.
I'm Chris Saxon. I'm an Oracle developer advocate for SQL, and I work for Oracle.
The 2-minute clock starts now.
So my 2-minute tech tip relates to external tables. So these are a fantastic tool to read files, CSV information into your database using SQL. However, they can be a bit tricky to work with. So quite often, if you work in a data warehouse or something like that, you're importing files daily. And those files, the name of those files often includes the date that they are for, which is a problem for external tables, because then you've got to change which file it points to every single day. You've got to run DDL scripts to do that, or you've got to rename the file, which is all just a bit fiddly and a bit of a mess. And it's particularly tricky if you ever need to go back and look at yesterday's data, for example, and want to re-query that. So what it'd be really useful to do is point your table just for an individual query at a new file. So this is something we introduced in 12.2. So there's the external table parameter override clause. And what you can do with this is temporarily, you just say external modify, and then the file name or the location of the file that you want to use. And then you can point it at any file you want. This makes it much easier when you've got these data loads looking at different files. So that's all great, but what if you're not just changing the file name, but you actually want to change the type of file you're looking at, the structure changes, it's got different columns in it. Well, that gets even more fiddly. Or maybe you're in an environment where you've got read-only access and you can't actually create tables. So what do you do here? A lot of questions come in, people saying, well, I can't create an external table. What do? How do I actually access this file using SQL? Well, we've got another solution for this. In 18c, you can now have inline external tables. What you can do is, in a query, generate an external table on the fly, so it only exists in your session. So this is a great tip for helping it work with these external tables.
Was that a good tip?
I think you've got what it takes.
We want your opinion. Thanks for watching, and stay tuned.